for children's church, youth room, cafe applications where you need a great 8-channel mixer, you can't beat the DL806 from Mackie. This is the latest in their version of iPad mixers. And as you can see, it comes with essentially a box with gain controls, or the trim controls here, and no other controls. You have 8 balance line mic inputs here, and you have 4 auxiliaries that you can run monitors with or for other purposes, and then 2 left and right outputs. And that's pretty much it for this box. You got a headphone output here. This is an iPad, and it's in a secure cradle. You can see it's bolted in this way, but you don't have to have the iPad installed for this mixer to run. You can remove the iPad and run it with the iPad separately. You can also run it with a iPhone or an iTouch or with a mini iPad. And you can run up to 10 different iPad devices or iDevices on this one unit. So just because this one has the iPad installed doesn't necessarily mean that you have to use it. That's just the easiest way to show it right now, and oftentimes people will use it this way. But if you wanted to, you could take this and put it in the back room somewhere and keep the controls safe. So let's take a look at the details now. So first of all, you see the 8 input channels. And the really great thing is that they've got labels for these. So you can see that this is clearly a kick. So again, when you're running a children's church type of an application or something where you're using a 12-year-old teenager or something like that for an operator, you can clearly see that's a kick. You can see a cymbal, the bass, the vocals, rather than using the channel numbers. All it does have those. If you want to relabel those, then you can go into a default name, or you can go ahead and label it right there. Okay. Then I can go ahead and do that all the way across. What you're seeing here on the individual channel is the input level. See that input level? So that tells you you've got a good signal. It's in about the right area. This is the fader part of that. You can see how that pops up and glows. So it has fader glow, and then drops down. So I know I've got it, I can move it back up, and now I see it. You have the pan control if you're running a stereo system, left and right. So then the mute control right there, and then you've got your EQ here. So to adjust the EQ, you simply use your finger. In this case, there's a high pass filter. I can slide that back and forth and take the high pass filter and move it in or out. I can adjust my low frequency, mid frequency, high frequency by just grabbing it. Or as you can see, the controls move on the bottom here as well. The high pass filter can be in or out, and I can adjust it right here as well. So whether you like to have a knob type of a configuration or whether you have a graphic configuration, it's very, very easy to do. For instance, on your sweep here, you've got gain, in other words, how much, frequency, which is where, and Q, which is how wide. So you go ahead and just that like that. You can see that's a very narrow filter, and that's a very wide filter. Now, one of the cool things they've come out with now is you can change from what's called a modern EQ to a vintage EQ. The vintage EQ is more of the knob type of an approach. You select where you want the control to work, and then you just simply go ahead and adjust the control right here, and you can see how many dB you're changing. I just really happen to like the modern because I can see what it is I'm doing here graphically on the frequency band. Now, there are other effects that the mixer will do on each channel. Of course, you've got a polarity switch right there. But if I want to get into reverb and some of the other effects, I just come right up here. So the first thing is a gate and a compressor. Very, very cool analog control here. And you can go ahead and adjust the threshold. In other words, where compressor or the gate will act, how much, how long it will hold, and then fast or medium releases. So you don't have a bunch of knobs here, but you have some selection. So very easy to set that threshold, have that gate kick in, you have a medium attack, medium release, which is typical for a lot of applications, for a drum or a vocal. You can go ahead and take the compressor, do the same thing, set the threshold, and go for fast or medium, and what it will do is control if somebody is not singing consistently, if there's a lot of variation in their voice, or maybe not playing consistently. This helps even out or ride the gain for you. You can go ahead and go up here, and there's reverb and delay, so you can add reverb to that channel, so you send a little bit more reverb, And again, some fairly simple controls here. Or you can go with delay and add a little bit of delay. Sometimes that'll help clear up monitors by putting a little bit of delay on it. Or, of course, you can use delay as an effect and do the tap. So you're tapping it to make sure that the delay is synchronized with the music beat. And then when you add in the delay, it will sound natural. Okay, let's go back to the mixer. So again, you've got the eight channels here with the input indicators. You've got the fader there. And if you want to send a signal from these channels to wedge monitors or in-ear monitors, you simply press an auxiliary. In this case, auxiliary one. Now you have what's called sends on faders. So these aren't the master for the main speakers now. It's for the monitor speakers. So I can go ahead and say kick. I want a little kick in there. I want a little bit of snare. Or I can say, you know what? All I need to have is on A1, it's going to be my vocal monitor. So I'll bring up vocals there and maybe a little bit of the lead guitar and maybe a little bit of bass. And I'm getting plenty of drum sound. I don't need that. So that's on A1. And I go to A2, same kind of thing. Maybe I want plenty of guitar. I want plenty of bass and just the lead vocal coming in on that for the guitar player. So it's easy to set that up. And then you can just sweep it over and you've got reverb, delay, and those are the returns for that you can bring in. And you have an iPad control, so you can bring in a track off of the iPad and play it back right through the mixer without taking up one of the external channels. So back to the master there, same thing, reverb, delay, and iPad. Some other cool things that you have on the 806, you have some show control. You can safe out certain channels. Say that you'd never want them to be able to adjust a couple of the channels. You can go ahead and safe those out. You can create snapshots, so it makes it very easy to take a mix that you've created that you really like and put it in a snapshot. So now somebody could actually run a small children's type of a program or youth program off of these five presets. Just store the snapshot with all of the mix the way you want it and have them play back with the snapshot. So that's very, very easy. Same thing with presets. You can come in here. You can preset these channels with EQ that you like to have and recall those. You can use the factory defaults or have your own. So you don't have to start fresh every week with a new attempt at trying to EQ and come up with a reverb mix. You can go ahead and store that in. The DL806 is a fantastic digital mixer controlled by the iPad Mini, or an iPhone. It's absolutely fantastic for eight channels or less, plenty of presets as we saw. Click the link at the bottom of this video for CCISolutions.com where you'll always get the best available price.